AWGS has been in the business of offering quality trophy whitetail deer hunts for over 35 years. One of the most critical components to being successful is being able to age a whitetail deer on the hoof so you can make your decision to shoot that much faster. This presentation is intended to help you learn how to do that more proficiently. Our operational program targets the harvest of mature bucks only. This means that you must be able to age bucks and determine if they are mature on the hoof within seconds of spotting them. While no two bucks are the same, they're no different than people are, there are a number of visual indicators that will help determine if the buck is a mature deer. We classify bucks into six distinct age classes with two groups, the first group being immature bucks, which are 1.5, 2.5, and 3.5-year-old deer, the second being mature bucks, which are 4.5, what we classify as prime, and bucks which are past their prime. The first classification of bucks are those immature bucks which are 1.5 years old. These are the easiest of all bucks to age. Their antlers are typically around ear length. They're often only spikes and with some smaller points, sometimes a real small basket rack. They're always very thin and they never have mass. From a body standpoint, their neck is always small, it'll never be swollen, and their head and their ears appear to be quite large on their body. Quite often, 1.5-year-old bucks will often look very skinny, just like the buck in this particular picture. These bucks tend to have very little muscle definition, especially when their winter coat has grown. 1.5, or commonly referred to as spike bucks, from a behavior standpoint, they act submissive. They're often following other deer. It looks like they're just trying to find their way in the deer woods. They often will stay in a local area, and you're likely to see them multiple times throughout a hunt if you sit there for an extended period of time. That brings us to the second easiest buck to age on the hoof, which is a 2.5-year-old buck. Typically, they'll have small basket frame, usually inside the ears, and very rarely do you see it outside the ears. And typically, they'll have 6 or 8 point racks. It can be other variations, but typically it's a 6 or 8 just inside the ears, very similar to what the deer in this picture displays. Another antler characteristic of 2.5-year-old deer is to look at the amount of mass, which they will not have. Their antlers will almost always be thin, and they'll almost never have any type of significant mass characteristics. A 2.5-year-old buck's neck will start to swell slightly as he's starting to rub trees, and it only makes sense that he's got a little bit more basket up on top of his head compared to, say, a spike as far as rubbing trees goes, but nothing that you expect to see in a mature buck. Their ears will appear to be quite large compared to the rest of their body, and again, similar to a spike, they'll often look quite skinny without any type of noticeable belly. Their belly seems to be quite flat. They have very little muscle definition, especially when their winter coat has grown. Things will tend to look very smooth. You won't be able to see any ridges where there's larger muscle groups growing. 2.5-year-old bucks will act submissive. They're often following other deer, similar to a spike, but they tend to be a little more curious in nature, especially to the breeding activity. They've seen it once, and they're kind of getting interested in it a little bit, but they shouldn't be part of the actual game itself. But they will often stay in a local area, and they're likely to be seen multiple times. They're kind of the local buck who's just kind of growing up. They're kind of like an 8-9-year-old kid. They're just kind of hanging around. You see them around the neighborhood. The last age class of immature bucks is a 3.5-year-old buck. This is the one that presents the biggest challenge to a hunter, and they're not accustomed to hunting Alberta deer. Most mistake bucks are this age simply because their antler to body size ratio is similar to a mature buck. However, because their body isn't as big, their antler size itself is smaller. 3.5-year-old bucks typically have a mid-size frame, usually out around their ears somewhere is a good rule of thumb, and they start to show some mass characteristics. So you'll start to see some mass in the beams and up into the points, but it's usually without any bumps or ridges or blading. So their antlers tend to look smooth. While their frame might be, you know, a little bit bigger, it tends to look smooth in general. Important thing to remember, because it really comes in handy sometimes. from a body perspective, their neck will start to swell. They take a noticeable jump from a two-year-old to a three-year-old because they're starting to rub that much more. They're getting closer to getting into the action. Their torso will appear to be more rectangular in shape, with the belly line running straight from the back to the front legs, as you can see by the rectangle in this particular photo here. So kind of rectangular, but really not sagging down like you would see in an older buck. 3.5-year-olds start to display some muscle definition. You start to see it become more noticeable, particularly in the front and rear legs, as this deer demonstrates in this particular picture. Not so much in the paunch or in the belly, but you can see that there is definition in this type of a view, whereas a 2-year-old, you wouldn't see that. Again, look at the rack like you can on this buck, and you'll see he's starting to show some mass characteristics. He's at his ears, but his antlers look quite smooth, all telltale signs of a 3.5-year-old deer. As you would imagine, 3.5-year-old bucks display the most typical type of buck behavior during the rut because of all the immature bucks, because they are the oldest, and they're, you know, they could be a year away from getting into the breeding, maybe even getting into a bit of breeding, if depending upon the health of the herd. But they rarely get that opportunity up here in the areas where we're hunting in Alberta. They're very, very similar to a teenage boy, if you're trying to equate it to human terms. They're hanging around the situation trying to feel their oats, but they're not quite ready to play in the game yet. AWGS recognizes a mature buck as being a 4.5-year-old deer, and the reason for this is very simple, is that after 4.5 years of growth, that deer's skeleton has reached maturity, so therefore any excess energy that goes into it is growing muscle and antler, no longer growing the skeletal system, which is the case with immature deer. 4.5-year-old bucks will typically have good size framed antlers with noticeable mass throughout the antlers. They'll usually be at least at their ears, maybe outside their ears, but you'll particularly notice the height, but the biggest differential is the additional mass. They tend to have rack sizes and frames that are larger, you know, maybe 15-20% larger than a 3.5-year-old, but you really notice the additional mass characteristics through the antlers. One of the keys to look for in the antlers when you're looking at a deer that you believe to be 4.5 years old, you can see more mass, is look for the little small signs, like little bumps and ridges and blading. It's normally present in a 4.5-year-old deer, and the antlers tend to look textured. They don't look smooth anymore like they do in a 3.5-year-old deer. And for the most part in Alberta, the vast majority of the bucks that are 4.5 years old, they're going to have 140 plus inches of antler on their head. So that's why, another reason why we classify them as mature bucks. The neck on a 4.5-year-old buck will usually be quite swollen, especially compared to that of an immature buck. They do a lot more rubbing, they're putting down a lot more sign, and therefore their necks get quite enlarged. At 4.5 years of age, whitetail bucks start to show three distinct compartments, noticeable compartments in their body when you look at them. The first two are ones which you've seen in a 3.5-year-old. You see the development of it, but those are the vertical sections, and that's the front and rear legs. Their muscle structure fills out, so you can start to notice that sticking out. But in addition, now they start the third one, which is a horizontal section, which is around their belly. It'll either start to sag a little bit, or it'll start to stick out, but you'll start to see it starts to take some shape, which is noticeable. So I like to refer to it as the three compartments that you only notice in mature bucks. 4.5-year-old bucks will exhibit typical behavior during the rut, including aggressiveness. They'll start to put on the miles looking for does, as they may be part of the breeding dynamic as they've reached the age where they're old enough to start playing that game. The next category of mature bucks are what we like to refer to as prime bucks. These are bucks that are 5.5 years of age, perhaps maybe even up to 7.5 years of age, but basically they're in the prime of their life as far as it comes to breeding. Their skeleton has reached maturity, so all of their energy goes into growing antler, and these bucks tend to have the most mass, the largest racks. They're in their prime as far as bucks which are trophy class deer. Prime bucks will sport good to excellent size frames with mass being carried throughout their entire antlers. Here's a good example of above average frame with mass that's carried all the way out on this prime buck who I caught working a doe. Prime bucks really have some different characteristics from a 4.5-year-old deer, and that's that their antlers have a lot more bumps and ridges and blading and gnarliness to them. They tend to look real heavy, and because of that extra mass, especially if it's against a white background, their antlers will look darker, especially at long ranges. You'll just notice the mass in them that usually differentiates them from younger deer. Another key aspect of identifying a prime buck at long range is the simple fact that you can notice their antlers with the naked eye at long distances, 250 yards plus. If you see a deer that steps out at a long range, you will know that if you can see something with the naked eye, that you're looking at a deer that has a lot of mass. And this video explains it quite well, showing this deer who is almost a half a mile away, and with the naked eye, I was able to see that this deer had antlers. This deer happens to be a mid-170s buck. Prime bucks will almost always have a huge swollen neck from doing lots of rubbing and just being really involved in the rutting activity. And typically you'll see that it looks as though their neck is just an extension of their body with a head attached. And this particular slide of a trail cam photo of this buck shows that quite well. It looks like a head on the end of an elongated body. Prime bucks look a lot like middle-aged to older-age men, in that they have sagging, round bellies. It's quite common. Their muscle definition is easily noticeable in all areas of front, rear legs, their shoulders, their neck. They tend to have short, stocky-looking faces with small ears. It's because they've filled out so much, and their legs appear to be quite short. They tend to look like a Brahma bull, like this buck in this picture does. Also, from a behavior standpoint, they tend to act like they own the woods simply because they do. They've reached the top of the pinnacle as far as in the pecking order, and what they want to happen typically tends to happen. This video, you can see this prime buck who is displaying his stuff. He's just walking around like he owns the woods. The final category of mature bucks that we classify are bucks that we call past prime. So these are bucks that are older than the prime bucks, and they're essentially the same as them, the characteristics the same, except their antler development is usually reduced somewhat. It's fallen off a little bit, and they tend to look old simply because they are. The antlers on a past prime buck typically have good to excellent size frames with mass throughout the antlers, but especially at the bases because their pedicles have grown throughout their entire life. So that's one characteristic. Their bases tend to be heavy. They'll usually have bumps and ridges and blading. It'll be predominant, and their antlers will tend to look real heavy and dark and gnarly, same as prime bucks, just maybe on a smaller basis. And again, they can usually be noticed with the naked eye at long distance. If you have a look at this buck that Tom McFarland took with us years ago, it's a prime example of a past prime buck in the mass that he has, thick at the bases, lots of little gnarliness and knobs, and real character deer. These bucks, past prime bucks, tend to be real character bucks, real trophies. Past prime bucks typically have a neck that's swollen from rubbing. It often appears that it's an extension of the body, again, with a head attached to the end of it. More often than in prime bucks, you'll see a sagging round belly will be hanging down, and quite often they'll also have a sagging back. If you see a buck that has a sagging back and a sagging belly, there's a real good chance that he's a past prime buck. He maybe looks a little bit tired because he just might be. Another common characteristic of past prime bucks is to have loose skin. You'll notice in the circle on this photo, you can see the folds of skin in the neck of this past prime buck. Another telltale sign that only past prime bucks possess is that it ties in with that loose skin, is they tend to have a pocket down around their brisket area between the front legs where they'll have this loose skin that kind of looks like a sagging pouch. And this picture of this definite past prime buck is a real good example of that. Their muscle definition is easily noticeable in all their areas, their front and rear legs, their shoulders, everywhere. They're well-muscled deer. They'll almost always have a short, stocky face with small ears, and quite often these past prime bucks will have a Roman nose. Their legs appear to be short, just like a Brahma bull. They've basically filled out their body as muscular and as big as it's going to get ever in their life. Past prime bucks behave like they own the woods because they either still do own the woods or they did at one time. They've been through the rut game. They know what to do, how to go about things. The only question is whether or not they're capable of keeping up with the prime bucks. Okay, now it's time for the payoff. Now that we know the difference between the different age classes, let's compare three bucks with very similar antler to body ratios. If you look at these three trail cam photos, if you kind of step back and just look at the antler to the body size ratio, you'll see that they're very, very similar. They're basically all 8 points or 9 points that have a similar antler to body size ratio. This buck is 3.5 years old. You can see that he's not well muscled everywhere. His neck is a little bit skinnier. He's got a, you know, decent sized frame. You can see the tines reaching up. They're starting to show some mass, but they look smooth. The antlers look smooth in general. Classic signs of a 3.5 year old buck. This buck is a 4.5 year old buck, showing all those signs of that type of deer. You can see his frame is up there. It's outside his ears. You can see that mass. Hard to make out any type of burrs and bumps in that in this particular picture. But if you look at the deer's body and you look at how his neck is a little bit more swollen, you can definitely see the muscle definition in the front shoulders, the rear legs, and you can start to see definition in the actual body and the belly itself. This is a good example of a 4.5 year old deer. This buck is in his prime. He shows everything. He's got mass carried throughout. He's got gnarliness, some little bumps and stuff down around his bases. He just looks big and huge and fat, muscled everywhere, big neck, short face. This is definitely a prime buck. This 3.5 year old buck scores somewhere in the low 130s is where he'd go as a 9 point. This 4.5 year old buck will score somewhere in the mid 140s as an 8 point. This prime buck will score in the high 150s as an 8 point. That extra mass, that extra length, maybe a couple little extra kicker points here and there is what gets him into that particular range. So again, as a review, hopefully this is really kind of hit home, and what you should really be looking at is looking at the scores of those three deer that basically look the same. From a distance, they're going to look the same, antler size or antler frame size to body size. But once you differentiate and truly look at the body to understand what those deer are, you can see by these scores how it can change. So a deer that's in the low 130s to a deer that's in the high 150s. From a distance, if you're just strictly looking at antler to body size ratio, you could have a difference of, you know, 25, maybe even 30 inches. So again, this is the payoff and the reason why we've put this whole package together and why it's so important to understand the differences between an immature deer and a mature deer. Now for some practice time. On the following series of slides, you will see a picture of a buck. I want you to have a look at the deer's body, have a look at his antlers, look at all the characteristics we just talked about, and guess what you believe that deer's age happens to be. It will then be followed by the same slide, which will pop up showing you what that deer's age is and his approximate score. This should be good practice for you, and it should help you out in the field. Good luck.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test and don't ask why. It's not a question but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. So take the photographs and still frames in your mind, hanging on a shelf in good health and good time. Tattoos and memories and dead skin on trial. For what it's worth, it was worth all the while. It's something unpredictable, but in the end is right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life. It's something unpredictable, but in the end it's right. I hope you had the time of your life.